Thanks. So, today you will be answering this quiz in math in modern world. So, the first question is, find out where the 25th percentile is in the above list. So, we have this. So, in order to find the 25th percentile of this, we have this solution. It's equals to 25 all over 100 multiplied by n plus 1. Now, why do I write 25 here? Because we are looking for the 25th percentile. So, 25 divided by 100 is 0.25. Now multiplied by n, which is 8 plus 1, so 9. So 0.25 times 9 is 2.25. So our 25th percentile is located at the It's located at the 2.25th place, so probably right here. So, and because there's no value given in the 2.25th place, we have to solve for it. So in order to solve for it, we will use we have to round off in either second place or third place, and since because 2.25 is closer to 2, we will round down to 2, so we will use 2. So our second unit is 33, so we will use 33 plus 10. Why 10? Because we have to minus, we will find the value that is located here, so we will subtract both of these. So 43 minus 33 is 10. So 10 multiplied by 0.25, because we already have our second value, which is 33. So we will find the 0.25th value. So 10 times 0.25 is 2.5. 33 plus 2.5. So our answer is 35.5. So this is our 25th percentile. Now let's move on to the next question. The following cumulative frequency graph shows the distribution of marks for the class of 40 students in a test. Use the graph to estimate A, the median mark, B, the upper quartile, C, the lower quartile, and D, the interquartile range. So, we already have, I will explain how we got the median, the lower quartile, and the upper quartile. So, we have a total of 40 students, man. So, yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. We have 9 values, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 0, 5, 10, 15, 20, 25, 30, 35, and 40. Now, it is stated here that our median is 20. Why? Because 40 divided by 2 is 20. So, meaning our 50th percent or our median is located on 20. So, this is our median. Median. I will just write M. Now we have to locate our upper quartile and lower quartile. Now, stated here that our lower quartile is 10 and our upper quartile is 30. Now let's prove it. So we have, this is our lower quartile, this area here, and this is our upper quartile. Now, in our lower quartile, we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 values. So it goes the same with our upper quartile. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, you only have to find the... we only have to do this. Okay, cancel this, and 10. So, meaning this is our quartile 1 or our lower quartile. Same goes in our upper quartile. And this is our third quartile or our upper quartile. So we have 10, 20, and 30. Now in the graph, we have here a line, this line. So we will use our lower quartile, median, and our upper quartile to find the values here in the marks. So our lower quartile is 10. Now we only had to draw a horizontal line until we reach the graph. And when we reach the graph, we go straight down. So that is the value of our lower quartile, which is 36. Same goes with the median and the upper quartile. Draw a horizontal line until we reach the graph and then go straight down. Now this is 44 and our upper quartile straight down, and we have 52. So this is our median, this is our upper quartile, this is our lower quartile 36, this is our lower quartile, and this is our upper quartile. And our interquartile range can be found by using this formula: upper quartile minus lower quartile. So our upper quartile is 52 and our lower quartile is 36. So our answer is 16. So 16 is our interquartile range. That's all, and thank you.